even imagine the Creator, the one that created everything and anything, asking you, what do you want? What would you like me to give to you? As we all ponder this genie in a bottle moment and wrestle with our response, I would imagine that for most of us, it would be a wrestling match between our desires and our needs. We all have desires. Those things in life that would be nice to have, that might give life a little more pizzazz or passion, even those things that are beyond our bucket list. We all have them. And we also have needs, those necessities, essentials, and basics of life, where many times our needs are simply downsized desires. As I read this passage and studied it this week, I had to ask myself, if God asked me, Pastor Mark, what can I give you? Would wisdom be at the top of the list? Would wisdom be at the top of your list? And the more I explored, the more I concluded that it should be. Many times I would imagine if people are asked this question by God, what can I give to you? We might directly go to wealth or abundance. And we all need a certain amount of wealth in which to live, but the danger lies when the accumulation of excess wealth becomes our deepest desire. Before us would be the question, what is wealth without wisdom? Why have wealth if you have no wisdom? Life is littered with stories of wealthy people whose lives were destroyed by lack of wisely using their wealth. Even Scripture, if you remember the rich young ruler who worked hard, built bigger barns, had created a fortune, retired, and died that night. Maybe your thoughts might be, if I only had more power, God. Now, we certainly are not created to wallow in helplessness or weakness, as I think power is a part of our DNA. But this same power can be used for destruction and death if not used wisely. So might I ask again, what good is power without wisdom? Without wisdom, power can destroy. With wisdom, it can sustain. Reverend Robert Schuller created an entire ministry claiming that our deepest need is our self-esteem. And while there may be a certain amount of truth, and there is importance to know our self-worth, without wisdom, that can lead to pride and arrogance and a superiority complex. So let me ask again, what good would wealth be? What good would power be? What good is our self-esteem if we do not have wisdom? Okay, so what is it? I'm glad you asked. What is wisdom? First, let me tell you what it's not. Wisdom is not intelligence. Praise be to God. Wisdom is not knowledge or education or sheepskin on a wall. We all know very intelligent people who lack in wisdom and very wise folks with no education. Wisdom is, however, a few things. It is the ability to make good judgments and execute correct decisions. I don't think it's ironic that on this All Saints Sunday I bring with you the words of Reinhold Niebuhr, who summarized this idea, this very familiar prayer that I use in almost all of my funeral services. You've heard it before. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and wisdom to know the difference. Whether it be our marriages, our families, our vocation, our spirituality, our success often rests in the ability to make sound judgments and decisions, aka wisdom. Wisdom is the ability to distinguish between right and wrong, right choices and wrong choices. In Solomon's situation of leadership, he wanted to discern right from wrong, good from evil. Boy, that sounds so simple, doesn't it? Let's all just leave here today and do the right thing. It sounds so simple. But if it were, I suspect we would have much less sin and turmoil in our lives. Because in general terms, right and wrong seems fairly black and white. But when faced with specific situations, sometimes things turn a bit more gray. But wisdom is also understanding. Something that plagued Jesus throughout his ministry with his disciples. Peter could not grasp the necessity of Jesus' death. Philip never fully comprehended who Jesus was. And even the two men on the road to Emmaus on that Sunday morning following the resurrection did not understand what just happened. And I'm confronted this morning as to how much do I truly understand. If we know that wisdom is what we ought to be asking for, if we know what it is and what it isn't, then how do we obtain it? I end with this. We obtain it through the Trinity. Wisdom is first a gift from God. Just as God is love and God is truth, God is also wisdom. Because only the creator of wisdom can offer us wisdom. And when the psalmist writes, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Next, Paul refers to Jesus, get this please, Paul refers to Jesus as the wisdom of God. The wisdom of God, and urges us to have the very mind of Jesus within us. So as we become more Christ-like, we are more intimately connected to the very wisdom of Jesus. And finally, we receive wisdom by the guidance of the Holy Spirit, where we are led to truth, good judgment, discernment, understanding, and wisdom. Because Jesus promised, as he leaves and ascends into heaven, he promised a counselor who is God residing within us. So as we prepare to come to the Lord's table this morning, one last question. How important is wisdom to us now?